YouTube, how's everybody doing today? This is Jeff, aka Three Lines, an AlgoBox trader, going over Friday's trades with you from July 28th, 2023. Waiting for news to come out at 10 a.m. That was why the market was a little choppy here. It's about 9:50 right now. We're going to take a headshot off of the higher time frame, the MACV. You'll see a pink dot. And then once the cross shows up, there was also a pink dot on the wave too. Now I'm only looking for T1, T2, because as you can see, we're above the ropes on all time frames. MACV histogram's green. We're just looking for a little T1, T2. Putting the stops back above the pink dot and the cross there. Finger over the close, and targets filled. Trade one. Trade two is a Enigma and a DCDM off of the higher time frame. So the Enigma pops up on the twos. And as you can see on the wave in the MACV, there's DCDMs up there. MACV is definitely green in the histogram. It's slanted upwards. And we're also at the high of the day, so I retrospect probably shouldn't have tried to go in with so many contracts, but I really liked seeing those DCDMs on the higher time frame. As well, there was a J hook. It's a little outdated, so I guess I shouldn't even keep that in mind. But it was, those targets were in the back of my head too. All right, so we got stopped out. We were able to close two of them before they hit our stops. The other ones did hit the stops. Trade three was a Enigma. I believe this is when the red Enigma popped up. As you can see up on the top left of the screen, we're now in the red and learn to like the dips, right? All right, red Enigma here in the sellers. Going for T1, T2. I pull out one runner, just a few ticks, not much though, because again, we are fully green on the MACV and above the ropes on the higher time frames. Finger over the close.
Target fill.
Harmonic NQ on the board.
And it seems like it comes right before your target, right? I was gonna dance around a little while. I'm not sure. I forget if I actually just closed it or I let it hit the target. Alright, so I close it as it's down there. I didn't want to wait for it to come back on me. Alright, trade four, so DCDM. It's basically, let me see. Okay, so this one here. So yeah, this was basically kind of like trying to re-enter on that red Enigma. So I really probably shouldn't have called it a whole new trade, even though the red Enigma played out. And then I basically re-entered where I got out, which wasn't the smartest thing in the world to do, because it could have been DCR, the fact that we are at that level there. Seems like we're forming an accumulation zone in that area. And again, with the high time frames being above the ropes, kind of fighting it by going short. Now, we're going to retry the DCDM from trade two, which was that green Enigma. If you look up on the wave, the green dot popped up, and I still had those targets in my head from the MACV and the wave, that those DCDMs were looking really good. So I was trying to get something out there, and I probably not the smartest thing to keep that in my head. That was my bias, and that's not good to have those type of biases when you're trading. You gotta be ready for anything, not assuming you know where the market's going. So in my head, I'm thinking, yeah, it's gonna go complete those, they're higher time frame, they're strong, the market's strong. instead of looking for just what's in front of me. And I think I forget if I, get punished for doing so. I think I might, I think this trade actually, it's like a break even. While we're waiting for it to play out, guys, go ahead and join the AlgoBox Discord room. It's absolutely free. You'll have access to the sounds you're hearing, the buyers and sellers on the tape, as well as the Mac VU, which gives you great overall context on the 4E minis, which can provide an extra form of confluence for you. Definitely helps. While you're at it, you can like the video, subscribe to the channel. It really does help out. So yeah, at this point, I'm realizing that, okay, we're starting to form an accumulation zone here. Let's go back up. All right, cool. So I got targets filled there on half of it. Now when it gets to the high of the day, I hit the half off button just because I'm starting to see that it's having a hard time breaking out to the upside. So like, let me leave one on. I took off. That's why I like that half off button. Instead of having to drag your targets down and all that, you can keep your finger right over the close. Be ready to add back on if need be. Here in the buyers, I just did not want to break out to the upside. And I mean, we see this a lot on Fridays, right? We see the big move in the morning, and then the rest of the day, a lot of times it can chop around. At the high of the day, or sometimes at the low of the day, wherever it has moved in the morning, and it just kind of stays there. And I think that's probably one of the main reasons why the Vinny's always said early in, early out, because the opportunities are, as well as you don't want to end the week on red. I mean, that's one of the worst failings in the world. But I was saying, if I can get a break up to the upside, I would add. I would definitely add to try to hit those targets there on the higher time frames from those DCDMs. But only if it breaks and then I see like a little retest. We're able to pull ourselves out of the red there. So we're just in the green.
Speed of NQ62.
Here in buyers, but price is falling. So that's another thing that had me thinking, okay, if I'm hearing, like a lot of times if I hear a lot of buying, but I'm not seeing the movement, then I start to get a little cautious on my position there. Same with the flip side. If I'm hearing sellers and the price is not moving, or even worse, it's moving against you a little bit, then you want to maybe start getting ready to have your finger over that close button. Now I'm hearing sellers, and just still kind of dancing around.
Harmonic NQ on the floor.
And then now I said, okay, there's a Delta flag. Now, I could have closed it before it hit my thing, but I'm looking to re-enter because I do see a clear accumulation zone here. So once I seen this double cross pop up after that big Delta flag, I definitely went in with a little bit of size too, I believe. Yeah. So I'm putting targets to the other side of the accumulation zone, and I'm putting one runner up just in case it does break out of that upside. But ready to close it if I see anything other than strength heading up there. So yeah, this trade super confident in. I can see the clear accumulation zone. I can see the lot of activity down there with the multiple crosses, even the alpha, the delta flag. So I'm assuming it's going to at least clear the accumulation zone. But just in case, fingers over the close.
Target filled.
Speed up and Q62.
Still here on buyers. We got some green up there on the top left, finally. So a great way to get out of those dips there.
Pip.nq on the 24.
And let me know in the comments, guys, if there's any other type of videos you guys interested in me doing. I don't want to just keep doing the same things. Maybe some ideas, and I'll do my best to make it come to pass, come to life, as they say. Here in the buyers. This is definitely a Friday type market right here. I've seen this more times than not on Fridays. Alright, so we're gonna close that up. I'm gonna re-enter on basically that same trade. Based off of the power dot with the alpha cross, and again at the bottom of that accumulation zone. Still really believe in that accumulation zone. I'm seeing a lot of strength, a lot of support there with clear resistance and that choppy back and forth action. Okay, targets were filled super fast. I didn't even get a chance to push out. I was able to get one runner out. But I'm not looking to let it come all the way back against me either. Hearing a lot of buyers on the tape. Alright, I'm out. It's just delaying back and forth. Alright, so we have a bonus trade here with the alpha cross reversal with the delta flag. So in that same area where we've been seeing the accumulation, so that the bottom of the accumulation zone, we got an alpha cross, we got a big delta flag. And hey, all morning price has been bouncing off of there, going back up. So why, you know, in my head I'm thinking, why wouldn't it happen again until I'm proven otherwise? But I'm up for the day now. That was the last ones were trade 5, and I really could just call it quits. Once it started dancing around a little too much, I just closed it out and ended the Friday there. Don't forget to leave a like, subscribe to the channel, do all those things. And then you'll see price does actually end up ripping to the upside, but I had to fight my impulses of getting back in and just left it there. So end of a good day, end of a good week. Hope everybody enjoyed the video. Get ready for tomorrow. I'll see you back here. Till next time, have a good one.